A new survey from the Pew Research Center finds the nation increasingly distrustful of the federal government. The findings released today show that about one quarter of Americans trust government to do the right thing, always or most of the time. A whopping 73% do not. And the survey blamed members of Congress. Asked if the political system can work, 56% responded that lawmakers are the problem, and 32% disagreed. Well, a big majority of Americans in a brand new poll say they simply do not trust the U.S. government. The number's the highest in half a century. According to the Pew Research Center, nearly 8 in 10 Americans, 8 in 10, do not trust the folks in Washington to solve our national problems. Only 22% say that almost always or most of the time they do.
Do you ever get the feeling that the news anchors on television are just mindless media parrots repeating the same talking points over and over again? Well, if you haven't, you might after seeing this.
In consumer news, economic factors may take some spring out of the Easter Bunny step this year.
I don't know about you, but I'm getting the feeling that economic factors may take some spring out of the Easter Bunny's step this year. But seriously, kudos to Conan O'Brien for once again exposing the media repeaters. Look, guys, obviously this is no coincidence. The question remains, where are all these news stations getting their scripts from? While there are affiliate news services that supply packages and scripts to hundreds of stations around the country, stations then have their anchors read the canned story with the generic script. Now, you might look at this and say, it's just indicative of how lazy local news can be. But consider the implications of this kind of reporting for one second. Say it wasn't an Easter Bunny, and rather, the story being mindlessly regurgitated was about a virus, a terrorist attack, or a report on war casualty counts.
We'll be right back.
bottom line is that people who watch the news tend to trust this information. Information that then influences their perception and decisions. So for these anchors to ask no questions, do no fact-checking, and hold no different interpretation of the news they're delivering is not only absurd, it's downright dangerous. Well, this might be old news to some, but last year it was confirmed that the U.S. military has been manipulating social media by using fake identities to influence conversations and spread pro-American propaganda. It's called Online Persona Management Services. And under the CENTCOM contract, it allows the creation of up to 10 sock puppet accounts for every U.S. serviceman or woman working on the program. The stipulations are that every fake persona must have a convincing background, history, and supporting friend networks so that it remain undetectable from even the most sophisticated adversaries. According to The Guardian, the project has been likened by web experts to China's attempts to control and restrict free speech on the internet, and that critics are saying that it allows the U.S. military to create a false consensus in online conversations, crowd out unwelcome opinions, and smother commentaries or reports that do not correspond with its own objectives. Now, of course, according to CENTCOM, their only objective is to counter violent extremists and enemy propaganda outside of the U.S., and that it would be unlawful to address U.S. audiences with the technology. Wow, unlawful, really? Interesting, because the newest version of the 2013 NDAA included an interesting amendment. This amendment legalized domestic propaganda on the American public. You heard me right. The newest NDAA wasn't just reauthorizing the indefinite detention of American citizens. It also allowed the U.S. government to legally carry out misinformation campaigns against the citizens of this country. But is this really surprising to anyone? I mean, the corporate media is basically a propaganda arm of the U.S. government anyways, isn't it? Why the need to legalize the use of propaganda when you already have an entire mainstream media establishment lacking to the White House, reprinting government press releases without question, selling wars, and carrying water for the administration? In fact, aside from everything I just mentioned, the Pentagon already spends $4 billion a year to influence public opinion, and the Department of Defense also spends hundreds of millions of dollars on information campaigns in countless countries occupied by the U.S. military.